Welcome to this Siomasoft screencast about how to install a Solaris 11 logical domain using VDCF. VDCF is a powerful management software from Siomasoft. It is used to manage and monitor virtualized Solaris environments. This screencast focuses on installing an LDOM using Solaris 11. Other videos are available if you would like to learn more about the product. On Oracle CMT systems, you are able to run multiple separated Solaris instances. The control domain handles the network and I/O services. The LDOMs own dedicated CPUs and RAM, and are running completely independent. VDCF requires to store the LDOM data on SAN storage, to be able to live migrate to other hardware. Here we are on the central management server, where we will use the VDCF commands to configure and install a logical domain. The control domain is already set up. We use T41 running LDOM 3.0. We have some resources left. 8 CPUs are available and about 4 GB RAM. Next, we check the available SAN disks, which are not used by other projects. Then we define our guest domain using the VDCF GDOM command. All the definitions are added to the database and later deployed to the control domain. We assign the available SAN disk . Then we assign some IP addresses. Every interface has a type assigned. The management type will be used to install the guest domain later. The public IP address is the address used by the applications. Now we check all the definitions in the database. All definitions are currently in the state defined. When we execute the commit operation, all these elements will be activated on the control domain. This creates all the LDM definitions required. The last step is to check the available build definitions. We now assign the latest update we would like to install to this guest domain. These builds are reusable definitions to quickly set up systems using the same software update. The enable install configures WAN boot and generates all the required AI manifests and profiles. The node install boots up the guest domain, configures the OBP, and then starts the WAN boot installation over the network. VDCF supports some post-installation of files, executing scripts, and here you see the elements which are automatically configured when the guest domain is installed. So DNS is configured, NTP will be configured, and some services will be disabled automatically. Using the console operation, we follow the WAN boot installation output. The installation of a guest domain takes a few minutes. We will skip the waiting time. You find more information about VDCF on our product homepage. The whole product documentation is available online. Try the product yourself using the free edition. Don't hesitate to contact us if you are interested in a proof of concept project.